I've known about Vero since they started making watches. The watch scene here in Portland, Oregon is small enough that the brand and I have crossed paths before, but this is the first time I've gone hands-on with a watch from Vero, and it was me who reached out to them when I saw a photo of this open water ridge trail. The open water is Vero's line of dive watches themed after the Pacific Northwest. The navy Crown Point, the gray North Coast, and this ridge trail in minty green. Certainly the boldest of the three watches and my favorite. The ridge trail gets its color from a bridge here in Portland, the St. John's Bridge, and it gets its name from the forested trail that overlooks the bridge, the ridge trail. I usually find the stories behind watches silly and gimmicky. Rolex makes a watch to celebrate something James Cameron did, or Omega puts Buzz Aldrin's ass on a dial. Those feel like corporate marketing, but here, for some reason, it seems sincere. Very few people know about this bridge, this trail, or this watch, so it really does feel like design inspiration rather than a marketing technique. I think there's an honesty to this watch, in its name, in its design, and in its impossibly good warranty. We'll get to that. But first, the facts. The open water ridge trail is 41 millimeters across, 47 millimeters long, and just 11 millimeters thick. I actually measure the watch at 40.5 millimeters across. It's water resistant to 200 meters, it has an anti-reflective coated sapphire crystal, and a DLC coated bezel. The case and bracelet are steel with a sandblasted finish. On the bracelet, the ridge trail is $875, and on this Haviston nylon strap, it's $810. For the extra $65, go for the bracelet. It has three micro-adjustment spots on the clasp and fully articulating links. I know how y'all love that. On my 7-inch wrist, the ridge trail is a perfect size for a dive watch. 40-ish millimeters wide, 47 millimeters long is ideal for me, and 11 millimeters thick is noticeably more comfortable than many deeper divers that are 12.5 or 13 millimeters thick. 200 meters of water resistance suits me just fine, but if you need 300 meters, then I don't actually believe you. It's refreshing to see a modern design on a dive watch, and not just modern, but modern without a hint of legacy or vintage inspiration. The case is angular and dynamic. The sloped black bezel is relatively wide for the dial, which I think gives a striking look. Bold, really. The rectangular white markers are outlined in black and applied on an unusually clean dial. There's only two words on it. I appreciate the restraint. And I appreciate the color. I've been increasingly drawn to color dials, and I think I'm not the only one. Lots of brands seem to be responding to consumers' desire for more self-expression and more fun. Maybe the pandemic has had something to do with it. I understand if this isn't for you. It's not for everyone, and that's one of the reasons I like it. The markers, hands, and several of the bezel hashes are filled with Superluminova. Now, I never truly need it, but I'm always a sucker for a lumed bezel. Despite the striking dial color, or maybe because of it, I think the ridge trail works well on lots of straps. Inside the watch is a Sellita SW200-1. Good. Very good for the price. And this is where things get even more interesting. Once the watch components arrive from Switzerland, Vero regulates these movements in Portland to plus or minus 5 seconds a day. They do this only after the movements are cased in the watch, and they guarantee that 5 seconds of accuracy. It's part of the brand's bizarrely good warranty. I usually don't talk about warranties much, but this one really caught my attention. Vero has a no questions asked 10-year warranty. I went to the Vero office and talked to them about this because I still can't get my head around it. If your watch is running faster or slower than 5 seconds per day, send it in and they'll regulate it for free. If you drop the watch and crack the crystal, send it in and they'll replace it for free. If you have some small scratches on the clasp from resting your wrist on a desk, send it in and they'll refinish it for free. For 10 years. A lot of smaller brands say things like, "We'll take care of you if something happens," and often they follow through. But to have that guarantee in writing is a different level of customer care. As an owner, I think that promise from Vero would help me enjoy the watch more. Maybe I'm unusual, but I worry about my watches. I don't baby them, but I'm also careful about abusing them. Scratches, hard knocks, children, you know. But here's a brand that's saying, we made a sports watch that you should treat like a sports watch, and we've got your back if anything happens. To me, that's freeing. And for the few days that I've had this watch, I've been wearing it every day. I like it a lot. I like what it represents. A small brand trying new, risky things. And the increasing, democratizing effects of digital design and modern manufacturing. It's a new golden age of small watch brands. But more importantly, I just like the watch itself. I like how it wears, how it looks, the price, and the fact that wearing it actually inspired me to get off my couch and onto a trail.